okay, vegan. You've answered questions about your protein, omega-3s, calcium, iron, vitamin D, B12, zinc, and iodine, which had a horrible intro, by the way. But I have one you can't possibly get. Carnitine. I mean, it has carn in it. Right? So, also, carnosine, actually, too. You know what? I've been quite the good sport throughout this, doing costume changes and various characters and attempting to make this all fun and approachable and, frankly, as my iodine video intro so excessively illustrated, I've run out of my nutritional mockery mojo. So you've left me with no choice but to utilize the inherently amusing facial structure and loud breathing of my bulldog to create a humorous visual directly before cutting to the opening logo.
Hey there, weakling. Yeah, you. Want to get strong and muscular like this beast? Want to spark your appetite for awesome and become a carnal, carnivorous carnivore like this? Then you need carnitine. Just take 1 2-pound jug a day and you'll be as built as this carnitine-fueled carnivore.
What a beast!
Get yours today and carn the
F up.
Hi, it's Emily from BiteSizeVegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. Today is the final video in the Where Do You Get Your Vegan Nutrition series with Dr. Michael Greger of NutritionFacts.org. I feel like we should have a moment or something. I'll just have my own moment. We've gone through some of the most common concerns when switching to a plant-based vegan diet and have come to those nutrients you find out about during a 3 a.m. Google search. Carnitine, often paired or confused with carnosine and creatine, or even taurine, is a quaternary ammonium compound biosynthesized from the amino acids lysine and methionine, which may not be helpful at all. As far as what it does, its main job is transporting fatty acids from the intermembranous space in the mitochondria into the mitochondrial matrix during the breakdown of lipids or fats for the generation of metabolic energy. Basically, it helps with burning fat for energy. This sounds like a great thing, right? Apparently so, as carnitine supplements abound. As far as direct food sources, carnitine is almost exclusively found in animal foods, though tempeh, avocado, whole wheat and white bread, peanut butter, and cooked rice do make the list. So, is carnitine, and for that matter, carnosine and creatine, something vegans should be concerned about? Let's hear from the doctor. So the final nutrient that we'll go over is something that, it's not something that really comes to someone, to people's minds in the very initial worries about a vegan diet, but it, usually once they've done some digging, they come across, you know, things about carnitine. And, you know, the term itself almost sounds like carnivore, so of course, you know, vegans will be concerned. So could you talk a little bit about what is carnitine? Like, where is it found? What does it do for the body?
Right, so there's a number of nutrients. Carnitine, carnosine, taurine, creatine, that are not made by plants. And you say, uh-oh, that's all I eat. What do? They're only made by animals. Well, guess what? You're an animal, right? I mean, and we make it. Just like the cow makes it that people eat, we make it too. We're animals too. And so we make all the, you know, carnitine we need, just like the cow does. For example, we have a requirement for vitamin C. If we don't get enough vitamin C, we get scurvy and die. But we actually used to be able to make vitamin C. We actually have the gene to make vitamin C, but our bodies basically junked it because there was no need. Why? Because we evolved eating plant-heavy diets, just like all our other great apes. Great ape cousins. And so all we're doing is eating vitamin C all day long. Why would we need to make our own? It seems wasteful, so we just scrapped it. Similar like cats. Cats need taurine. Cats need taurine in their diet. Why? Wait a second. We make all the taurine we want. Why don't cats make taurine? Why would cats need to make taurine? They get all the taurine from all the mice that they eat. So let the mouse make it, and then they don't even have to. And so the fact that we don't make some of the plant-based nutrients like vitamin C, but we do make the animal-based nutrients, kind of suggests that maybe we were meant to eat lots of plants. Because we don't need to eat animals because we make all the animal kind of derived, these animal derived, typically they're kind of amino acid configuration. So anyway, now having said that, you need to have the enzymes that create these compounds. And about 1 in 40,000 births is a hereditary disease. It's a carnitine transport protein disorder where you actually still make all the carnitine you need, but you actually lose it in your urine. And so in about 1 in 40,000 people, they actually need to do carnitine. So I report that I have a video about this kid in Israel about 30 years ago. He was in and out of the hospital every couple months. They didn't know what was wrong with him. And then he went vegetarian, and things got really worse. Like, he was in the hospital every couple weeks. And that was the clue. Aha! And turns out he had this rare 1 in 40,000 carnitine problem. So when he went vegetarian, all of a sudden he wasn't getting it in his diet. He was losing too much of it in his urine. So anyway, they gave him carnitine supplements, and he did fine. They continued to be a vegetarian, actually. And so there are indeed rare cases in which, you know, there's some biochemical abnormality where you'd have to actually take in supplemental form. But for the 39,999 kids that are born out of 40,000, they make all they need.
I hope you enjoyed hearing from Dr. Greger on this final nutrient. At this point, I typically tell you that if you want to track your own carnitine, to check out Carnometer. But it actually doesn't track carnitine because it's a non-essential amino acid that we make ourselves. And as incredibly awesome as Carnometer is at tracking your daily nutrition, fitness, and even supplements, it's not quite good enough to track what's going on inside your body. Yet. But seriously, it's a totally free service and pretty awesome-tastic. I'm running out of adjectives. So much so that they're actually sponsoring this video to get this vital information out to you. Be sure to use the link in the video description below to go make your free profile. I don't get any money when you click on it, but it lets Carnometer know that I may be someone to work with in the future, even though the Vegan Nutrition Concern series is over. Now, I'd love to hear from you on this. Is carnitine or carnosine or creatine or even taurine things that you've even heard about before? If you're vegan, is it something that you are concerned about? If you're not vegan, is it something that you worry about not getting when going vegan? Do you supplement or just allow your body to make its own? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this final nutrient of a nugget, give the video a big thumbs up and share it around to spread the nutritional truth. You can find the playlist to the entire series in the info card sidebar and the video description below. If you're new here, be sure to hit that big red subscribe button down there for more awesome vegan content every Monday, Wednesday, and some Fridays. If you want to help keep BiteSize Vegan educating, check out either of the support links in the video description below. And for perks and rewards for your support, just click the Nugget Army icon there or use the iCard sidebar on your phone. And hey, check out some of the related videos while I'm here, which are also linked down below. Now go live vegan, make your own carnitine, and I'll see you soon. Nope, getting attacked.
What a beast!